So we're switching cameras. Now we went to the camera that is walking. So here we are at Arosta Creek, one of my favorite locations. One of these places that I don't care how many times you go to it, it's still intriguing. And looks like there's a pretty hefty trail. This is not somewhere where nobody has been, because there's a lot of trails coming through here. Art has not been to Arosta Creek. That's why we got to get him down here to see it, because there's a lot of stuff in this one location that makes it pretty special. So that's the original, I believe, house or fort, you might call it that, of the sheep herders right here. And then you get over here, and then you start to see the pens. Look at this walls. They're still standing here today. I've got a drone shot of it somewhere. Look how cool this is. And then there's one of these things that are one of my favorites. If I could not fall down. Is when they put the ancient stuff in with the new. So they built some of this wall. Look at this wall. I mean, this is something everybody should come see. Look at this wall. Incredible. And then you've got a chute, like where they ran them in and ran them out right here. So you have a little more modern. But again, the same techniques for building the walls were the same, whether it be 1,000 years ago, whether it be 150 years ago. They would have herded them into this pen right here. Now, one of the things that are my favorite, and if you do come here, you don't miss, is this rock structure right here. Because there's some things in that are absolutely incredible. See, this wall goes all the way down. Look at this thing. Spectacular. Look at that. Now they'd have herded them in here. Look at the amount of work it would have taken to do this. Now we're gonna go through here, try not to get through all these tangly stuff. See if there's a way to get across over here without. Here we go. One of the amazing things that I love about this location is this right here. I'm going to show you. Look at this worked rock up here. Now this would have been 1,000 years ago right here. 800 to 1,000. Look at these couples. This rock would have been worked for hundreds of years. Now petroglyphs, they would do this to these rocks. A little petroglyphs over there on that rock. Look at that wall. Look how crazy this is. Highways right over there. You'll see along this ridge right here all kinds of grinding holes. So it would have been a nomadic location for a long, long time. They would have been traveling through here. And then again, when you see things like this and you see the amount of time they spent here, and you've seen the amount of petroglyphs that are actually here, they're hard to see on these darker rocks. How incredible is this? This is another level for somewhere that you don't get. Look at that. Yes, look at that groove right there. Look at that. That is pretty cool. Looks like one of them ribbons. You don't see, this is one of the, other than the one in Superior, these are pretty incredible. do this the easy way today. Let's not make it hard. Let's go easy. These walls are just fabulous. If you drone this, it's unbelievable to look at them in a drone. It's absolutely, definitely spectacular. Now, I don't know sheep herding, but it sure seems like when you know kind of where you run into these sheep pens, you see them along this ridge. When I say this ridge, I mean a ridge that goes 50 miles up in these higher mesas. You know, I don't know if the grass that's up here was brought here, because I know that the grass we went through was invasive. It's not natural. So, I don't know if they brought that here or someone else did or somehow it got in here. But it definitely likes it. And then coming down here, you're going to see some of the most spectacular work. Look at this work rock right here. Now they're all over here. And a lot of times this has been had some water in it. Really a lot overgrown compared to the times that I've been here before. Now you just look at those rocks right there and you're like, oh, it's just a place. That's what's weird about this place, is there's so many petroglyphs you can't see unless the light's right. That's what's so bizarre about this place. And then you get that right light and this place explodes. Let's just get in here and take a look. So first thing you see is that grooved rock right there. But they're all over here. Just amazing that you can't see them. You see it over there too. But if you're not here in the right time, it's extremely difficult to see. Because this is one spectacular place when you see all the petroglyphs that's on this. They're everywhere. But if you looked at it right now, you'd just think, oh, there's nothing here. There's a spiral there. There's a bunch of stuff on that wall. And then down here is stuff everywhere. It's just like I said, the problem is you can't see it. Unless you got the light just right, you can't see it. Now if you come out of here, I'm walking this trail, but along this ridge, if you walk that ridge, there are grinding holes everywhere. So you start going through here, start seeing these rocks. Start seeing these grinding holes right here. And they're everywhere. So you look through here. There's a grind. They were using this as a kitchen
area.
Art. There's hundreds of these grinding holes on this ridge. So they were all just sitting up here. Here's a good one. There's one here, 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 here. This big circle right there. A few petroglyphs. Bunch of them if you really look.
Yeah, they're all right.
And they knew to peck them deep here. Definitely if you're into this stuff, you definitely want to come see this place, because it is a very sacred place still today. You know, and even the fun thing is when you come here again, after not being here for a while, it's still incredible. You see petroglyphs all over.
Yep.
I think that one said, go see the law possum. I'm not sure, but I'm thinking that's what it says. Look at that wall up there. Just how much work that had been to haul them rocks. Man. I guess you can haul out of rocks if that's all you got to do today. There ain't nothing better than Arizona. How could you go from 5 million people, Art, to me and you in about 45 minutes? It's pretty cool. And you can use the land. Look how deep this is. A chute right there that they drove them in up there to either butcher them or to shear them. They had to run them into this pin and separated them out up here.